Hey there, Jon Chorba here from reallyeasyguitarlessons.com, and in this video lesson, I'm going to teach you how to play the rhythm guitar part, the song Once by the band Pearl Jam. So this is just what would be considered Stone Gossard's part. Stone Gossard is basically the rhythm guitar player of the band. Mike McCready is the lead guitar player of the band. In this lesson, I'm just going to cover the rhythm parts, which are basically Stone Gossard's parts. So I'm just going to walk you through this song section by section. We'll listen to a little snippet of it. You'll see what it looks like in the tab. I'll walk you through the technique, what the fingers go where, how many strings are played, what techniques are used, et cetera, et cetera. And then we'll work on, you know, transitions going from one section to another, and then also talk about the song order, how the whole thing is put together. So let's get started. All right, let's take a listen to the intro to the song, which is also basically the chorus with a little modification at the end. So here is the intro of the song. This is also slowed down to 75% speed. You're hearing it in Guitar Pro, so you're going to hear the original recording along with the Guitar Pro computer-generated guitar sound. Okay, so here we go. So I'm going to break this down by showing you what your left hand is doing in terms of what, you know, shapes you're making. Then I'm going to break down what the rhythm of the right hand is doing, and then we'll put them together. Okay, so with the fretting hand, you're making three chord shapes where your second finger is going to stay stationary on the seventh fret of the G string. So I'm not a finger stickler, by the way, so if you want to use different fingers that feel more comfortable, no big deal. As long as you get the sound right, that's all that matters. But I'm using my middle finger on the seventh fret of the G string, and then my third finger on the eighth fret of the G string, and I'll call that the first chord. And so when I play this, I'm playing from the D string to the B string, open D, seventh fret G, eighth fret B. I'll call that chord one for right now. It's got a name, but you don't need to know it. All right, the second one is gonna be, you're keeping that second finger stationary, and now you're gonna use your first finger on the sixth fret of the B string. And then the last one is gonna be the fifth fret of the B string. So you're just changing the note on the B string to either the eighth fret, the sixth fret, or the fifth fret. So the eighth fret I play with my ring finger, the sixth fret I play with my index finger, and then I just scoot that back, that first finger, and play it on the fifth fret there. So eight, six, five. So it's worth it just to kind of just get comfortable with changing between those three chords. Okay, so that's what your fretting hand's doing. Your picking hand, your strumming hand, is doing this rhythm. It sounds like this. Okay, so da ka ta 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 ka. You really want to get that caveman sound in your ear. If you want to convert that to pick stroke motions, I'm going down, up, 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 down, up. Okay, so that's the motions that your picking hand is going to make, and we're just going to change between those three chords with that rhythmic motion, okay? So I'm going to break it down into small little chunks. The first one is, okay, so you're on that first chord with the eighth fret and going down, up, down, up, down. Then you're going to change to the sixth fret and go up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Okay, so. Okay, stay on that second chord, start the rhythm over again. But on that first, if you break the rhythm into two parts, right? Down, up, down, up, down is part one, and then up, down, up, down, up, down, up, that's part two. On that second measure, you change chords on that last downstroke of the first part of the rhythm. Right there. Down, up, down, up, down. And then you stay on that chord for the back half of the rhythm, but the chords climb, the first time through, they climb from that 5, 6, 8. Sounds like this. Like that. As you get back to that first chord, and you see, sometimes I use my pinky finger, so when I say I'm not a finger stickler, I'm not really a finger stickler for myself. So sometimes I'll use my pinky finger on that 8th fret note, sometimes I'll use my ring finger, and again, I don't really care what fingers you use, right? So here is the whole first line of this that's the crux of the whole chorus. And then the ending of it is gonna go, you know, hold that second chord with the 6th fret of the B string, and I'm gonna hit it 4 times. And then I'm gonna hit the open D with an upstroke, a pull off on 7 to open of the D, the open A with a little slight palm mute. All right, so I'm gonna just loop this opening intro and play along with it. All right, let's take a listen to what I would call the main riff, and it's also the pre-chorus to the song. Here's what that sounds like. Okay, so the tab for this admittedly looks pretty scary. There's a lot of weird notation going on. And I'm gonna break it down into small little chunks. Okay, first, some notation things. When you see notes in parentheses on guitar tablature, specifically guitar tab that was created with the Guitar Pro software, there's usually two reasons why you will see a note in parentheses. One, it would be called what's a tied note. It just means that this note happens and then it sustains over into the next piece of the measure, or sometimes over the bar line. But in this case, a parenthesis note in this tab is referring to what's called a ghost note. It's a note that's there, it's played, it's just not really, really prevalent. So when you see these notes in parentheses, play them, don't omit them. But if you can, try to change up your dynamic pressure on that note and don't over accentuate it. That's what the ghost note means, okay? So that's that. These slashes mean slides. The arcs here are gonna refer to hammer-ons and pull-offs. This symbol is a downstroke, that symbol is an upstroke. PM means palm mute. Let ring means this note right here is being sustained out. We're not deadening it. And then X's mean muted notes, okay? So I'm gonna try to do this kind of one little piece at a time, all right? It starts off with a... I'm hitting the open A, the 5th fret of the D string, and I'm sliding 5 to 7. And then I'm doing a down up on that 7th fret note as that E string rings out. That first downstroke, when I'm doing it slow, it's gonna be really hard to, you know, make that sound like a ghost note. All right, but it's just a down up. If you can make that down a little bit lighter, that would be preferable. If not, no big deal. Okay, and then the next section, you're just gonna pick the 8th fret of the D string and do a pull off, hammer on, pull off. Like that. So we put those two together right here. We have. Next little part, we're gonna slide that 8th fret of the D string up to 10, come back to 8, pull off again, and two little palm mutes on the A string. So that first measure is gonna sound like this. All Okay. Then the second part of this is almost the same. Starts the same. Got that two pull-off hammer-on things, but at the end of it, you're gonna stick the landing on that eighth fret of the D string and give it some vibrato. So when you play the whole thing back to back, you get this. Okay, and then you repeat that first section again, right? Instead of doing it on the open A, you do it on the open D. And then this little part, this only happens once in the song. This is like the transition from this main riff into the first verse. I'm gonna just highlight that so you can hear it. Ba da ba da da ba da ba da ba da ba da da ga da ga da ba da ba da da ga da ga da. So that's just on the seventh fret. Da da ga da. So those notes, I'm making them a little short and stabby. I'm not holding the pressure into them like that. So it's palm muted and the notes are staccato. They're short and stabby. And we're going down, up, up, down, 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 down. And then on the fifth fret of the G string, hitting that, sliding out, finishing with a little two mutes, okay? So here's the whole main riff. I'm gonna play along with it, 75%. All right, getting into the verse now. I'm gonna highlight just the first two measures of this. So the verse, it's just these two measures right here that just get repeated one, two, three, four times, okay? So it's just one little thing that gets repeated four times. Just gonna loop the first two parts of it. Da 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 da. All right, so you want, again, you want to get these rhythms in your ear. It's very important that you think in music and think in what I call caveman sounds, all right? And then we're going to translate that to this. So I'm going to start off with a hammer pull with palm muting on the D string. So 5-7-5, hammer pull with palm muting. And then I'm going to make a position change, moving my first finger up to the 7th fret. And I'm gonna, still palm muting. And the palm muting is, it's a light palm muting because sometimes he accents these notes. It's hard to get it 100% right. I mean, when you listen to, you know, Pearl Jam play this live, they're not matching the record exactly. But on the record, he plays it in a really cool way where some of these notes are accented a little bit more by just easing up the palm muting. It's tough to get it exact, but if you could get close, it sounds really, really cool. So I do a hammer pull on 5-7-5, position shift, hammer, pull, hammer, pull. See how I do that? I'm like just slow, very slightly, just lifting that palm mute up a little bit on that second part to let those notes have less muting. Kind of lets them swell. And then after you do that, you're muting the string, down, up on the D string. And then on the 12th fret, it's a very slight, can be palm muted, right? You hit it on the 12th fret, slide off of it, and then give two more chukka mutes on the D string. Chukka, chukka, down, chukka. Chukka, chukka, down, chukka. Chukka, chukka, down, chukka, okay? Then you repeat the first part again. Same with the second part, but instead of doing 12, you do 14. And you just alternate between those two things. Okay. So I'm going to play the whole first verse along with it, 75%. Here we go. Okay, then it goes into the pre-chorus, which again is, it's the main riff. Everything's the same except the end of it. We now have some power chords. Sixth fret of the E string, eighth fret of the A and G string. Same rhythm as the as you did the main riff in the intro. One, two, three, four. And then the end of that. It's a down, it's a 16th note, down, up, chucka, chucka. And you're transitioning from this back into your intro riff. And so as you're doing that, just catch the open strings as you're making the transition, and it'll sound really smooth. So if I play, here, I'm gonna play this measure into that measure so you can just hear this real quick. So that's gonna be a little tough challenge. Getting to that chord. Making sure you're hitting the right amount of strings, okay? So again, that is just the pre-chorus is the main riff. And then you're into the chorus, which is again, your chorus is just your intro riff. Okay, and then that builds back up into your second verse, which is the same as your first. Same as your first, with the exception of one little part. Right here, there's just a little accent. If I play along the second verse, I'll show you where it is. Right there. It's a little accent, okay? So instead of going to 14, instead of doing that note, you're gonna do the fifth fret of the G and the B string. It's called a double stop when you play two strings at the same time. Give it a little vibrato. Okay, so that's the second verse, and then it goes into the second pre-chorus, which is the same as the first one, and then it goes into the second chorus, which is the same as the first one, and then we get to the guitar solo, where the rhythm guitar is actually quite easy. Let's take a listen to the solo part, just the rhythm guitar parts. Okay, so it's just an A power chord, followed by two pull-offs, two to open at the G, two open at the D. Back to that A power chord, and then we transition to the open G power chord, where you got the low E, the A string is muted, and we're just really playing to the B string, also known as the AC/DC power chord. You strike that twice. Dum, da 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 bum, dum, 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 da 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 dum, 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 dum. So you do that three times until it gets to the end of it. You hold that A, You don't do the pull-off little fill. You then transition to a B-flat power chord here on the first fret of the A string. And you're gonna go down, down, up, down, up, up. Change back to the A. All right, now we are into our bridge. Let's take a listen to the first part of it. So we'll go with the first four measures first. Okay, so we have our similar chord one shape that we had from our intro and our chorus. Okay, and we're gonna do 16th notes, down, up, down, up, on that. And then a down, pull off six to open of the B string. Then six of the G string, downstroke, some vibrato. Five of the G string with some vibrato. And then as you go back to the beginning of that, hit the open G and B string like that. So if I play it on a loop, I have. So the first time you do it, you add that open, those open strings. And then the second time you do it, you add this fill, which is open A string, hammer on a three, and then an upstroke on the open G. Okay? And then then you see that it's just first part with the open strings, second part with the fill, and then you repeat that. And then as it builds back into the chorus, right? Same idea, but we have a different little melody. Let's just take a listen to those four measures. Okay, so it's that simple shape. Again, you're doing a down, up, down, up, on up, but this time it's a little bit lighter with some palm muting. Like that. Then pull off. And then slide to 10. Then pick 10, 8. Like that. And then finish with a little chucka-chuckas. And then as it builds, sorry, changing my finger on that. You got 16 notes on the 8th fret. Taka-taka, and then add the chord. Rhythm is. Taka-taka-taka-taka-taka-taka-taka-taka. And then you're back into your chorus. So let me go ahead. I'm gonna play from the solo to the start of the third chorus at 75% so you can hear it. So your third chorus is the same as your first and second choruses. And then you get into the start of the outro, where you just bring back elements of that bridge riff. So let's take a listen to the outro. As you can see just on the tab here, it's got that element of the bridge riff, and then it's got the element of the chorus. So you got kind of bridge riff first half, chorus riff second half, and that repeats for the first four, the first four lines of that. So you redo it four times where you do it like that, and then you're going to switch. Let's just take a listen to it so you can hear it. Okay, so you see, it is pretty straightforward. It's the first part. Da 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 ba da da. Open G string as it changed back to the chord now, the second chord, where it's 6 and 7 of the B and G. You got your rhythm. All right, same as the chorus. So it's kind of just a combination of bridge and chorus. Play along with that. And then for the end of the outro, you just go back to the bridge riff. And this whole little section, you're just going to get repeated. You see it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times before we end it. Okay, it sounds like this. Dunka, dunka, da 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 da. With some little ghost note stuff in between it. So again, you repeat that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times, and then at the end of it here, right here at the end of the song, you have your 6-7 chord fragment twice, 5-7 chord fragment twice, open strings as you transition to your AC/DC G chord. Let me just play the last part of that. So that is the whole song. I would work on each section one little bit at a time. And it was some of those, like the main riff and the verse riff with those hammer-ons and the palm muting. It's tough to get them to be exact. So that's why you always want to work in little chunks, right? Just take, you know, one or two beats at a time. Have some sort of technology to slow and loop it. If you're using the Guitar Pro software, it makes it really, really easy to do that. You can just highlight a section of the song, slow it down to whatever speed, and just loop it and just focus on that little section, and then just work little chunks at a time. You know, take the main riff, work two to four beats at a time, and then once you get a whole section, you know, add it into the next one that you're working on. And then also work on transitioning from like the main riff to the verse, right? You just take the butt end of the main riff and the first part of the verse, you loop that section, so you're working on changing between stuff. But other than that, other than getting like the rhythm down, those little finer points of the technique, which are tricky, the structure of the song is pretty simple, right? It's just working through those riffs, rotating them over and over again, and you see elements, themes kind of repeat themselves from, you know, riff to riff. So that's it for this lesson. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you next time.